Incredible track, one of Dylan's absolute classics, which is on an earlier Dylan classic too, which is on his earlier albums. I read Dylan's biography. It was huge, man. It was like this big. It was crazy, but it was phenomenal. Like every page I was on the next. Like I should make a separate video actually. It should be a separate video talking about Dylan's biography. But like I was like want to know what happened after every page. And what was cool is every time I'd read the biography, I would, or as I was reading the biography, I'd listen to the albums in concession with the biography. So wherever I was in the 60s or 70s or 80s, I'd listen to that album, and it was really cool. This track is phenomenal. In fact, I actually when I listened to it, I also saw, actually, no, I'm sorry, I was thinking about a different track. I was thinking about what I was about to say was I was thinking about "It's Alright, Mom, Only Bleeding." That I was gonna say. I believe I saw. I think. What show was it? It was some 19 like 60, live performance. But not this track. "Don't Think Twice, It's All Right." But still, incredible track. Let's get right into this. "Don't Think Twice, It's All Right," and let's hope that Apple Music, their lyrics follow like they're supposed to.
Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, baby, even you don't know by now. And it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, baby, it'll never do somehow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone.
Vibrato.
You're the reason I'm traveling on, but don't think twice, it's all right.
All right, let's talk about this right here. So first off, it blows my mind, this song being, this album came out 1963, I'm gonna guess. Let's see, it's Freewheeling by Bob Dylan, 1960. Hey, I'm getting pretty good at this. 1963. One of the things that really blows my mind with this track, or this album actually, if we're going to talk about this album as a whole, is that it's all acoustic. It's voice, acoustic, and harmonica. And like for it to be such a profound album, with it being so simple production, music production-wise, really, really blows my mind. And then you take it a step further, and then you have, you can't say it's a simple album because like the lyrics are insane. He's an insane lyricist. He's got a classic melody writing. Every artist has their own melody style. He has a very classic one himself. Where he tends to go up da 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 da, or you da 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 da. He has this, and he pushes that the vowels and stuff. But it's his style. It's cool. I find, it's cool listening back to these songs and listening back with like the lyrics and stuff and seeing how like writing has changed. And like we don't use "I'm a traveling on," like where does the A even come from in that? Like how in the English language do we have that? But we don't use it anymore. It's just a very interesting thing, just in general. But let's keep going.
And it ain't no use in the turning on your light, baby. The light I never knowed. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, baby. I'm on the dark side of the road.
I want to just rewind. It's a cool lyric right there. Hold on a sec. I just want to hear something that I heard in the right ear. I want to hear if it was a guitar or the harmonica. I almost heard like he hit the harmonica on accident, which would be very interesting. Because one thing that Bob was so, especially earlier in his career, was so adamant on was these like one takes. He's like a one take wonder king, and like which blows my mind. Like, which I like really appreciate, and like a part of me wants to like throw out all of my music gear and go back into like all of my digital music gear and go and get just straight up like an 8-track. He was doing this on tape, but like I can't afford a tape machine. $25,000, but instead I would get like a cassette, 4-track cassette recorder or 8-track cassette recorder. And it really requires a talented musicianship. It really requires a dedication to what you're recording. It really requires you to like kind of really think about your songs, but also like a level of commitment. We just you know, it's we almost to some degree how Polaroids or film cameras made you really think about what you take a photo of. Where now we have 17 different photos of the same flower when we go, you know, see like, oh, that's a really pretty flower. Let me take this angle. Like we don't like. There's something about the simplicity, and which is why I have probably, you know, I mean, my walls are filled with Polaroids because I love them. I love the simplicity of the moment, and we lost that in music a bit because we have the ability to. We lost that actually in a lot of things. In film, we lost it in music. We lost it in photography. We lost it. Shoot, we lost it in our text messages. I can now unsend a text message, so I don't really even have to think about necessarily what I'm going to say. I can just unsend it, right? And it's a beautiful thing because it opens up a new opportunity, but there is still something lost. It's like anything in life, there are pros and there are cons. So you just have to weigh the pros and cons. And some things are a pro and some things are a con.
Never knowed. And it ain't no use in turning on your light,
Do you hear
babe.
that? I almost, when he says turn it on, it sounds like he hit the harmonica. Like, I wonder if like air blew into it.
And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe.
Do you hear that?
I'm on the dark side of the road. But I wish there was something you would do or say to try and make me change my mind and stay. But we never did too much talking anyway. But don't think twice, it's all right. So it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal, like you never done before.
You know, let me pause really quick. I just have a question. I don't know the answer to this. Reverb back in the 60s, how was that achieved? Like, now we have plugins for it where like you can like just do it on your computer, or you can even you know, then I know even before the plugins they had hardware, which would be like actual, like it almost would look like this. This is like, you know, an audio interface where I'm recording things into, but like it would look like that, and it would emulate digital reverb. Did they have that in the 60s, or like did he was that is that a natural reverb that we're hearing? Because it's a big reverb sound. Another thing I wanted to comment on is, you know, I'm thinking about the harmonica now. One of the things that one of the few gripes that I had with listening to his music, now 60 years later, when I would listen to it, it was almost always I'd go be going for a run, and that's how I do it, and it would be very early in the morning. You know, I'm an early riser, so it'd be like somewhere between like 4:30 and 5:30 in the morning that I'd start, you know, my run, and I'd be listening, and it'd be like really nice, and I'd be enjoying it, but then the harmonica would come in, it would be like so loud. I always gripe that the mix level between the voice and the harmonica. To me, it was too loud. And I was thinking about this now. I'm like, I if he did this all in one take, there was no second microphone for the harmonica. He played it right into that microphone, which would very much be the reason as to why it would be significantly louder than his voice. And now looking back, you know, I understand that. Now, I don't know if you could have like when you mixing it, if you could track it lower, I don't know, but I'm not noticing it so much here as I had in some other songs.
And it ain't no use in calling out my name, gal. I can't hear you anymore.
Oh, hear that? Hold on a sec.
Hear you anymore,
just rewind a little.
Gal. I can't hear you anymore.
Yeah, that little like I don't even know what you call it on the cant.
I can't hear you anymore. I'm a thinking and a wondering, walking down the road. I once loved a woman, a child, I am told. I give her my heart, but she wanted my soul. But don't think twice, it's all right.
Big reverb.
So long, honey, baby, where I'm bound, I can't tell. Goodbye is too good a word, baby, so I just say fairly well.
What a crazy line.
I ain't saying you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kind of wasted my
What a
precious time.
crazy lyric, man. This lyric is crazy. It's like, what a dig right there, man. The whole thing, man. Oh my gosh.
But I don't mind. You just kind of wasted my precious time. But don't think twice, it's all right.
Crazy. He's so young here too, man. The writing ability is incredible. The recording ability is incredible. Like, I don't really even know at this point what else to talk about. It's what blows my mind is, you know, how young he was when he wrote these, and just all about it, man. It's just, I mean, I guess I said all I could I talked a lot in this video actually, but incredible. Let me know what you want to check out next. I'm looking forward to seeing what the next Bob Dylan track we're gonna look into is. Peace out.